Okay, so what we're using here is store-bought drywall compound. We're going to use a 4-inch tape knife and show you how to tape the joints. Again, make sure all your screws are recessed first before you start this. Alright, so what you want to do to tape the joints is get it up on the tip of your blade like this on one side. And I go across, I'm going across like this. Get in there pretty good. Just kind of get right across there. Supposed to go at an angle like that. Smear it in there. What you're doing is making a bed of mud to press your tape into. Megan.
Shoot.
What? Forgot to do the paper this side. Fill in this gap. And then the first and our paper tape. And just want to span the gap, try not to go past where we. A little bit more mud. Cross and just use your mud knife and press that in. Okay. That thing's saturated. Sometimes you get it, it'll punch up there. Just pull it a little tighter.
You can see how it's flush with the wall?
Yeah, it's flush with the wall. And press it a little bit more and make sure it's not sticking out and get as flat as possible. See the trouble down the road. There you go, there's your tape. Can you try over here?
Yeah. Like that. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Come at an angle.
Do whatever works for you.
Too much up here,
huh? Yeah, it's too much. You'll get it later. Come back. It's not going to dry too quick.
So you
got to
fill in that whole big hole? That big hole?
You want to get a good bit behind there. We don't want to overlap this really too much.
Okay.
Make sure you just keep it within our where we cut.
Okay.
Just kind of get it set there where you want it. It'll stick.
The whole way down to the bottom?
And I'd take it just down right down to the trim. Maybe a little, if you can push it underneath the trim a little bit, push your knife in there and then just pull it. Rip it, tear it. There you go. You got it set in there and you want to work to one side, so I'd work the way down.
Just like down?
Yeah, go underneath. And see, you don't want to run on the wall here because then you're not going to press. You want to be on the tape, this edge on the tape. Put your pressure on that side, pushing in. You know what you want to do. It's all about your pressure you put on, right?
Yeah.
and put a little bit mud there. And put more pressure on the right and kind of guiding left. Make sure I get mud underneath, get that all squeezed out, because if that doesn't have mud underneath there, it's not going to stick and it will come loose. When you paint it, it'll just be loose there, so you gotta make sure plenty of mud underneath it. Let that mud squeeze out. Get that all pressed in there really good. And when you're doing your tape, you're not worried about getting final smoothness on there. You do that later.
Okay. Typically,
there's a corner trowel. It's just to have one of those, but you had this corner here, so. But you can do it this way. This is called a hawk. Drywall. I bought this one, but you can use a board or whatever. I'm going to use this because it makes it easier to do with this. With a little, see how nice strip on there? Put that on the tip, put that in and pull it out. That on the tip, and then you're pull it out. Can't do it in the bucket because it's round. On the tip, you get in there, push it in. Okay, so the tape comes, that's what the good thing about paper tape is, it comes pre-folded. So you get an inside corner. You just fold it. Stick it in here. Corner trowel, you just run your corner trowel right down there. It's a 90 degree. But you have one, so I'm just gonna work my way. Pushing this in too far, I'm just pulling out the. This is where the corner trowel comes in, because sometimes you can slice that tape with the edge of the knife. Okay, so then the easy thing to do is the screw holes. You got a little bit on the corner there. Well, sometimes it will do that if you see what happens with that sound. Now, the screw's sticking out too far. It won't let you do it flat if it's not sunken in, so that's a lesson learned there. So you gotta get a screwdriver
and push it.
Yeah, and do that one.
Same thing.
So that one, so put that screw there. Yeah. You go, see? There you go.
Yeah.
So here's the final product. So we finished up for today. Megan has become a fixer. She did an excellent job, and hopefully she learned a bit, and so have you. And we'll finish out this drywall repair and a plaster wall. And thank you for viewing, and check out my other videos. Good job.
Thanks.